मैं शिवांगी शिवराज कणसे फ्रॉम यशवंतराव चव्हाण इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ साइंस सातारा, पीजी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ माइक्रोबायोलॉजी, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर. टुडे वी विल बी सीइंग अबाउट ऑन्कोजेनेसिस. इन शॉर्ट, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय कैंसर? सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द लेक्चर. ऑन्कोजेनेसिस, इट इज़ अ प्रोसेस ऑफ ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑफ अ नॉर्मल सेल into a cancerous cell, where this cancerous cell, it acquires a property of division and redivision and uncontrolled cell growth. In this manner, the transformed cell grows into many cells, grows into a heap of cells, and this mass of cells is known as a tumor. Now, as far as oncogenesis or transformation of the cells is considered, the normal cells of any eukaryotic cell or eukaryotic organism, human being specifically, normal cells, they grow or they divide, and this cell division of the normal cells, it provides the requirements of the body, where the cell division is required as the growth of the body, growth of a particular tissue type, or replacement of the cells, or the repair mechanism of the cell, where the older cells are replaced by the newer cells, and this is known as the wear and tear mechanisms of the body. So the normal cells, they grow at a specific constant rate, and this cell division of in the normal conditions, it involves specific cycles of the division of the cell, and it has certain rules and regulations where the cell number is controlled, or the cell divides to fulfill the needs of the particular tissue or the particular the organ of the body. But in case of transformation of a normal cell into a cancerous cell, the main effect of transformation is loss of growth control, loss of cell division control. This transformed cell, it goes on dividing and redividing, thus forming a heap of the cells or a mass of the cells, which is known as tumor or a cancerous cell. So you can see over here, a cancerous cell which undergoes rapid and an uncontrolled growth at the cost of the remaining cells is known as the tumor. So such tumor cells are also known as the neoplastic cells, or the process is known as tumorogenesis. So the process of transformation of a normal cell into a cancerous cell, which has many different properties which differ from the normal cell, but the main property is that this transformed cell shows the properties of abnormal growth, abnormal cell division, which results in division and redivision, dividing and redividing of a particular cell type which has been transformed into a mass of the cells, which is known as a tumor. So there are different types of cancers, and these cancers, they account approximately more than 200 types of cancerous cells or cancer types are present. In the figure you can see some different types of cancer have been characterized, that is some common carcinomas, that is carcinoma of the lung, breast cancer, then the colon cancer, bladder, prostate gland cancer of the men. Over here you can see the leukemias, which involve the bloodstream, lymphomas, which involve the lymph nodes, and some common sarcomas, that is, which involve the fat, bone and the muscles. So in general, you can say that there are these many types of the cancers, and as far as the types of the cancer is considered, you just name the organ and you have the cancer which is present in the organ. That is the colon cancer or the lung cancer or the kidney cancer. So there are so many types of cancers, but in short, you can classify the cancers or see the types of the cancers as it is seen in the figure. That is so. After seeing the different types of the cancer, we will move on to the classification of the cancers. Now, classification of the cancers. First point, it is based on the growth pattern of the cancer. So how the growth occurs in cancerous cells, this becomes the point of classification of the cancer. First is the benign tumors and the malignant tumors, which is based on the growth pattern. So benign tumors, benign means sleeping, a sleeping condition, in a dormant condition. So benign tumors, as the name goes, it is an abnormal persistent cell division that remains localized on the spot of the origin. This is known as a benign tumor. Such type of tumors, they remain localized at the position where they are. They do not spread out, and they are formed of different well differentiated cells. These tumors are found to be covered with they are enclosed in a lamina. So they are covered with, such cells are covered with a specific covering which is known as a lamina. These cells, they do not spread throughout the body, they remain localized. And a good example of these benign tumors is warts. Warts, you can see in the picture that warts are present in the first picture, you can see it. And the importance of the benign tumors or the danger situation of the benign tumors, it is corresponding to the place of the benign tumors where it occurs. That is, the benign tumors, if they occur in the brain or in the liver or in kidneys, such important organs, if benign tumors or such type of tumors occur, definitely this will result in the loss of functioning of such important organs, which may prove to be fatal in such patients. So it is not that the benign tumors always are very harmless. The harmfulness of these tumors, it depends upon the position where these tumors be or where they occur. Now, benign tumors, they can be excised as they are covered by the lamina. They can be excised by minor surgeries. But anytime if these minor surgeries are not successful, the benign tumors, they are found to be converted into the malignant tumors by some unknown mechanisms. So the benign tumors, the cancers of brain, heart, kidneys, these are the organs which are involved, as we have seen in the in the first points. The next type of the tumors is the malignant tumors. Malignancy means spreading. So malignant tumors is the tumor cells which are carried out by the bloodstream or the lymphatic system into various types of the body, various organs of the body. So these malignant tumors, they have the property, or the cells of these tumors, they have the property to invade the other cells, to attack the other cells. They have the property of direct penetration to the other parts of the body, and therefore they can be transferred from one part of this body to the other part of the body. And this malignancy occurs at a very higher rate depending upon the type of the malignant tumors. Malignant tumors, they spread quite at a faster rate, and therefore you can see that within a few weeks or a few months, these tumors, they spread so fastly that the organs are studded with the tumorous growth of the cancerous cells. So for example, a patient having the lung cancer, a patient having a colon cancer, if malignant tumor is present, within no time, within a few weeks, the colon or the lungs will be found to be studded with the growth of these cancerous cells, which naturally hampers the functioning of these important organs. So, first classification, that is based on the growth pattern, benign tumors and the malignant tumors. Next is the classification based on the tissues involved. Which tissue is involved is also, this forms a mode of classification of the tumors. Carcinomas, first type of the second type of classification, which is based on the tissues involved. Carcinomas, which is principally made up of the epithelial cells of ectodermal and endodermal origin. This forms the solid tumors of liver cells, the nerve tissues, the skin cancers, brain cancers, the cancers of the body surfaces or their attached glands. These are the examples of the carcinomas. The skins, it forms approximately 85% of the cancers. So this is the examples involving the skin cancers, breast cancers, cervical cancers, brain carcinomas, etc. Now certain types of the carcinomas, that is the basal squamous cell skin cancer. So this squamous cell skin cancer, they are common, but they are usually very treatable. Next is the melanoma skin cancer, which they are likely to grow and spread, and more common types of the skin cancer. Next is the Merkel cell skin cancer. So these are the different types of carcinomas: basal cell, squamous cell skin cancer, melanoma skin cancer, Merkel cell skin cancer. The next classification involves the lymphoma of the skin, the Kaposi's sarcoma. Lymphoma of the skin is again the skin cancer type, and Kaposi's sarcoma. Now, after seeing the classification of this cancer, which depends upon the involvement of the cell tissue, we will see the figures that are involved, which will give you a picturization of how the classification of the cancers, or how many you can picturize the types of the cancers. So basal and squamous cell skin cancer, you can see over here, this is the type of the skin cancer where the skin is involved, basal and squamous cell skin cancer. Next is melanoma skin cancer. Next type, you can see Merkel cell skin cancer. Next is the lymphoma of the skin. This is again a skin cancer type. Kaposi's sarcoma, a cancer type which is also found in case of HIV patients. This is a symptom which is seen in the HIV infected patients. So these are the types of the cancers which have been picturized over here. This is not to frighten you, but to give an idea that how the skin cancers, or what are the types of the cancers and how they look like. Because unless and until you see the pictures, you will not get the idea of how they look. Next point of classification is the sarcomas. These sarcomas, the next type of the cancer, is they are classified on the basis of they are the tumors which are made up of connective tissue cells, which are made up of which are of mesodermal origin. So connective tissue cell type of a cancer made up of mesodermal origin are known as sarcomas. These are the solid tumors which involve the cartilage, bone, muscles, etc. They are found to be making 2% of the human cancers. So sarcoma types, you can see in the figure, that is the angiosarcoma, that is the malignant neoplasm in the vessel walls. Osteosarcoma, osteo means bones, osteosarcoma, Ewing sarcoma, chondrosarcoma, gastrointestinal stromal tumor, liposarcoma, fibrosarcoma, and the sarcomas of the vesicular neoplasms. So this is about the sarcomas. The next is the leukemias. Leukemia is also known as the blood cancer. That is, it is also known as liquid cancer. The cancer made up of blood forming cell, specifically the hematopoietic cells. Hematopoietic cells, these are the cells which are found in the bone marrow, and these are the cells from which different types of cells are formed, blood cells are formed, hematopoietic cells. Leukemias account for approximately 4% of the hematopoietic cells. They are found to produce excessive amount of WBCs than the normal cells. Excessive production of WBCs, they are of no use to the immune system of the body because they do not carry out the normal functioning of the body. And as excess amount of WBCs are formed, the amount of production of red blood cells, it is reduced. So this directly hampers the immune system of an individual, blood cancer, so the liquid cancers. There are four types of the leukemias, that is acute lymphocytic leukemia, ALL, which is the cancer of the lymphocytes, acute myelogenous leukemia, that is AML, cancer of the granulocytes and the monocytes, chronic lymphocytic leukemia, CLL, and the chronic myelogenous leukemia. Most common types of leukemia, acute myelogenous leukemia, which occurs both in children and in adults, acute lymphocytic leukemia, which occurs mostly in children, it is also found to affect the adults, chronic myelogenous leukemia affects mainly adults, chronic lymphocytic leukemia, it affects mostly people over the age of 55. Now, what is leukemia? It is the cancer which is found in the blood and the bone marrow, where it is caused, which results in the excessive production of the white blood cells. And this results in, as I told you, results in decreased capacity of the immune system to fight against the pathogens. So four types of leukemias, you can see acute lymphoblastic leukemia, acute myelogenous leukemia, chronic lymphoblastic leukemia, chronic myelogenous leukemia. This is the different types of the leukemia. So you can see over here the differences in the normal blood and the leukemia. Normal blood, you can see different types of cells which are present in proper proportion. These cells, they have a particular number of the cells which occur at each cell occurs at a particular concentration, whereas in leukemia you can see that there is increase in the WBC count. So you can see over here again the bone anatomy also in case of the leukemia patients or the cancerous patients. Now, the next classification is the lymphomas, cancer of the lymphatic tissues, which involves the lymphocytes, the lymph nodes, lymph vessels, the lymphoid organs, and which accounts for approximately 5% of the total cancer. This is the lymphomas. Now, lymphoma, the name itself denotes that is it is concerned with the lymphatic system. Two types of lymphomas, Hodgkin lymphoma and the non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Hodgkin lymphoma, it has large binucleated cells, which is called as a Reed-Sternberg cells. Hodgkin lymphoma, it is, the peculiarity is, or it is prominently recognized by these type of cells, which are large and binucleated cells, which are known as the Reed-Sternberg cells, which are found to be absent in non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. They do not contain the Reed-Sternberg cells. So these are the pictures of, or the, you can see the diagrams of the lymphoma which involves the Hodgkin lymphoma. You can see over here how the spleen cells, they are differentiated into the lymphomas, excessive production of the lymphocytes, etc. So Hodgkin's lymphoma, Reed-Sternberg cells, you can see over here. The normal cells,
in the normal human beings, they do not contain these Reed-Sternberg cells, which is a characteristic of Hodgkin's lymphoma. And over here, again, Hodgkin's lymphoma or the lymphomas with the excessive production of the lymphocytes in the lymph nodes of the spleen. You can see here the excessive production of the lymphocytes in the lymph nodes, and the swelling is due to the excessive production of the lymph nodes, and which is the over the capacity, excessive capacity of the normal lymph nodes, and therefore the swelling is seen over here as an example of lymphomas. So in this lecture we have seen what do you mean by tumor, what is tumorigenesis, how the normal cell is transformed into a cancerous cell, and we have seen the classification of the cancer, classification based on two types. One is the type of the cells that are involved, and the next classification is the type of the organs that are involved. So two different types of classification we have seen, and I now end the lecture. Yes, thank you very much.